Hello lovely people and welcome to my investing channel. I decided to invest £100 each month in the stock market using my trading 212 platform. On this channel, I will show my investing journey step by step, and as I learn more and more about investing, I will share that information with you and also hope it can relate to you. In today's video, we are talking about the breaking news of the week, Cineworld. Cineworld is a British cinema company and is the world's second largest cinema chain in the world. It has 790 sites and it operates in 10 countries. The company was founded by Steve Winner in 1995, and the first Cineworld theatre opened in Stevenage in 1996. Cineworld is listed on the London Stock Exchange and is currently part of the FTSE 250 index. The company will temporarily close all of its UK and USA cinemas from 8 of October 2020, leaving as many as 45,000 workers unemployed for the foreseeable future as it strives to survive the impact of the global crisis on the film industry. The shares were down more than 50%, reaching 15 pence at one moment in the day, and after a couple of hours it concluded at 25 pence. The balance sheet for last year found the company in a net debt of $8 billion, current assets around $400 million versus liabilities of $1.5 billion. Cineworld was the most heavily shorted stock on the London Market Exchange. Despite all this news, the current share price is now very low, and if the company will get even closer to liquidation, you will pick the shares up around the 3 pence per share. At this price range, there could be value in buying the stock for a future recovery. I was lucky enough to sell my shares in the company a couple of weeks ago, and I do not plan to buy in the next 6 months this stock. If you decide to buy this stock, please be advised of the danger of losing your investment. On the other hand, the potential gain can be enormous. If you found this information useful and wish to see more content, please make sure to drop a like, comment and subscribe to the channel. Regards. Disclaimer, I am not a financial advisor. If you seek financial advice, please see a licensed professional.